Going to read in Exodus. Exodus chapter 17. Exodus 17. From verse 9. Exodus chapter 17. From verse 9 onwards. And Moses said to Joshua, "Choose us some men and go out, fight with Amalek tomorrow. Tomorrow I will stand on the top of the hill with the rod of God in my hand." So Joshua did as Moses said to him, and fought with Amalek. And Moses, Aaron, and Hur went up to the top of the hill. And so it was when Moses held up his hand that Israel prevailed. And when he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. But Moses' hand became heavy. So they took stone and put it under him, and he sat on it, and Aaron and Hur supported his hands, one on one side and the other on the other side, and his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. The church may be seated. May God speak to us through His Word. My brethren, the great truth is that the Church of the Lord, it only has and will always have their opposers. In the same way that Israel, there on those days, he had to face Amalek and his army. In the same way, we, every day, we have to face Amalek. The struggle is always ahead of us. Because Jesus, he said those things. In the world you will have afflictions, but I overcame the world. So the battle is constant. It's constant. But we don't want to extend it too much because there are many details. There are many things here to be mentioned, but this is not the appropriate day for this. As summarizing, the victory there, it came through to an obedience. Why? Because Moses, he gave an instruction, right? Israel obeyed this instruction and Israel didn't question it, and the victory came. So the victory of the church is in obeying the Lord, right? Because when we do so in that way, we are victorious. Because in us, we don't have this strength. The Bible says that the hand of Moses was heavy. So there are moments in which the trials make us feel like that, heavy, overbearing. But the Lord says, "Come to me, all of those that are oppressed and overloaded, and I will relieve you. Take upon yourself my yoke, which is light and tender. So when we pick up our yoke and the yoke of the Jesus, we will be victorious. We're not going to be victorious by our own capacity, by our own strength, by what we understand, or by philosophy. Many are using philosophies in order to attempt to win the world. So then they go there, they buy a book about philosophy, and that person begins to read about philosophy, about those advices that are mere advices from other men that are flawed, and they begin to put that in practice in their life. But the victory of the church is in the dependence on the Lord. We will defeat the world by our faith. The John says this, that our victory, that we will overcome the world through our faith. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So today we are here. We are going to proceed to the prayer. We are going to pray tonight for the families. We are going to make two groups, Wayne, myself, and we are going to pray for the families. So the brethren may start getting ready, sitting together. Three groups? Okay. But we only have two deacons. Okay, we're going to begin. Initially, we start with two groups. If we perceive that the time is too advanced, then we're going to do something else. But for starters, we're going to start with two groups. Let us begin. And I'd like to ask that the brethren, as soon as you receive your prayer, we're not going to take too long here. Please do not leave the church unless there is a necessity, very special. So stay, because you are part of these dynamics here, of this prayer. Amen? So it is necessary. So at the end, we're going to pray, closing the service.